Hello and welcome to the Getting Started with SOTI MobiControl series. My name is Richard, one of the senior principal instructors here at SOTI, and I'm excited to have John, another principal instructor, joining me today.
In this video, we'll be discussing enrollment policies. You'll learn about bindings, how to create an enrollment policy, and explore various provisioning options.
We'll also conduct a hands-on demonstration of enrolling device using a QR code, showing you how policies and profiles are applied in real time.
To get to our enrollment policies, we're going to click on the hamburger menu and then scroll down to policies. From here, you can see we have a whole host of policies, but we're going to work with enrollments today.
Okay, so when you go into enrollment policies, we can actually see that there's a few that we've already got set up and running. And please note, one enrollment policy could be used to enroll tens, hundreds, thousands of devices if, let's say, for example, we have the same model, platform, and enrollment type. So for example, all company-owned Android devices are being enrolled to a staging area before being moved to their end device group.
Likewise, if we wanted to enroll our devices directly into the configurations that they'll be using out in the workplace, we can do that as well. So from here, we're going to click on Add Enrollment Policy, and then choose from our family of devices.
And as we've been using throughout this video series, we'll be selecting Android Enterprise, as we're focused on a work-managed Android Enterprise. And as we've referred to a number of times throughout this series, naming is important, so we'll make sure that we give this a clear name, indicating what this enrollment policy is being used for. Underneath that, we then have a binding. John, what's a binding?
So think of a binding as a way that we actually can get access to the Google Play Store. On our own devices, once we have the device in our hands, we're going to log into the Google Play Store, right, and then be able to download applications that we want to use. In this case, with a binding, we're actually doing the same thing for a whole organization. So giving everyone in the organization that has a device access to the Google Play Store and the applications that are approved by the company is what we're going to use our binding for.
Absolutely, so it provides access to Google Play applications, but in a very, very controlled way through SOTI MobiControl by the organization administrator. To actually set up and link a Google Play account to SOTI MobiControl, we can head over to the global settings area of SOTI MobiControl. And then underneath Android, we have Enterprise Binding. And it's a case of clicking the plus button next to Manage Enterprise and following the steps of linking the company Google account. Now, if you're interested in more information about Android Enterprise and about how the binding works, we do recommend having a look at Google's own academy in relation to this.
Okay, getting back into our console here, we've chosen our binding.
That's it. And before we move on though, we can actually see there's options of none. So we've looked at some of the benefits of managed Google Play, but in what situations would an organization choose none?
Well, if we don't need any or want any of the applications that would be available through the Google Play Store, we could choose none. Likewise, if we're all the applications that we're using or we're sending to the devices through packages, we would choose this option as well.
Yes, so this can be used, for example, in an offline situation in the case where the devices aren't connected to internet. And as John's mentioned, the only thing that's being provisioned to the devices are company inbuilt applications. Though please note, planning is important. If, even not now, but some point in the future, you are considering giving access to public play apps, a binding is worth considering. We'll click next, and then we're onto the device type. So throughout this series, we've been referring to work-managed, company-owned, dedicated devices, and that's going to be our focus for this enrollment video as well. So we'll be selecting the first option called work-managed. However, we can see there's two others as well. So John, could you just give us a quick definition of what these two are?
Sure. So when we're looking at the difference between a work profile and a corporate personal profile, we're really looking at who owns the device. For a work profile, the device is owned by the device user, and we're setting up a basket for information that's related to the company. Whereas in the corporate personal situation, those roles are reversed. The device is owned by the company, and there's a basket of information that can be used for personal information. So for example, the email addresses of my friends and family are something I don't necessarily want the company to have access to, but on my corporate personal account, they would be in a secure basket that's only accessible to me.
Okay, so We've got Work Manage selected, focusing on those corporate-owned devices used as kiosks for inventory management, etc., and on to the next page. And this focuses on groups, but we do have an option for authentication as well, with the option of either making sure that the individual who's provisioning the device, the person who's setting the device up on the device side, either has to enter a, let's say, a static password at the enrollment step, or select a directory. So the case here would be integrating a directory to SOTI MobiControl so that user credentials, such as the username and password of the individual, would be entered at the enrollment stage.
So I can see how this would really be helpful in understanding who's using the device.
Yes, so if the device is actually being issued to a particular individual, the directory can be integrated with SOTI MobiControl, and that user can enter the information as they're provisioning the device. In our situation, we'll be using a static password, and we'll see this referred to on our device setup walkthrough in a few minutes' time. Now we've got that set, we'll then move down to our device group, and we're essentially saying where the device is going to live, where it's going to reside once it has been provisioned. We'll choose our device group here. And we're on to the final page with a number of different options, a number of different settings that can be configured. So firstly, we have the enrolled device name. And we can see that this defaults to Android Enterprise and then an auto number value, meaning the first device that's enrolled will become Android Enterprise 0001, the next will be 02, the next will be 03, etc. But it's very, very easy to add further values or change the name if there are particular requirements.
Absolutely, and by clicking on the gear here, we can see a whole host of other identifiers that we can add to our device name to make it easy to identify them in the console.
So John, I can see underneath the name you have a number of different options. Let's say, for example, that a device is enrolled in SOTI MobiControl, but it gets damaged and it needs to be taken out, unenrolled, because it maybe needs to be sent back to the shop for repair. How can these next two options help us out with that?
So if we choose Preserve Device Location and Preserve Device Name, this will help MobiControl to locate the device that's been enrolled previously and put it back into its original device group. If we don't click these, then the device would be enrolled as a brand new device.
Further options include making sure that the latest plugin is deployed to a device. So most Android Enterprise devices require an additional plugin that is deployed shortly after enrollment to allow features such as the remote control to work. And then underneath that, we've got the permissions, which we can see currently all these permissions, such as drawing over other apps, modify system settings, etc., are all marked as enabled by default. Please note, in terms of how this works when the device provisioned, will vary a little bit dependent on the manufacturer and model. So for example, some device models, once the device is enrolled, these will all appear as prompts for the device user to accept. So John, are there additional restrictions that we could add to this specific enrollment policy?
Absolutely. So by clicking the enrollment restrictions on, you can see that we can limit the number of devices that are allowed to be enrolled with this specific policy. We can also set restrictions by criteria. For example, the manufacturer or the model name of the device or even the serial number to make sure that only devices that we've chosen to enroll into this group are enrolled through this policy.
Okay, so there's a lot of granular control that can be set up for each individual enrollment policy. So we click finish, and as we click finish, are we done?
We have everything that we need for our enrollment policy, but now we need to get the devices into the system. So we're going to look at three options today, starting with Android Agent Enrollment ID.
Okay, so with the Android Agent Enrollment ID, we're looking at a factory set, reset, or brand new device. And in the setup steps that the device would go through, rather than putting in the Google account, you can actually put a code that will automatically prompt the SOTI MobiControl agent to be downloaded.
And once the agent is downloaded, we can use this enrollment ID that we're seeing here.
Okay. Next, we have the option of an APK file.
With this option, we can actually download an APK file that we can put directly on the device as a way to get it enrolled into MobiControl.
And this option could be really beneficial for, let's say, those offline examples that we mentioned briefly earlier. But please note, though, that these would require some additional steps. The device would need to be synced via USB to a laptop, and that laptop would need to have Android Debug Bridge installed on it. Please note that there are a number of helpful resources from our SOTI experts on SOTI Pulse if you have a use case like this. And thirdly, we have the QR code option.
Using this option, we would actually get a QR code that we can use to enroll the device. Now, there are some things that we can further configure, for example, the Wi-Fi SSID and the security information so that the device would automatically be discovered on the Wi-Fi network and then be able to be used once it's enrolled.
So this really speeds up the enrollment process because, of course, that factory reset device or that brand new device is going to receive its Wi-Fi information, as well as everything that needs to be enrolled into SOTI MobiControl, and of course is provisioned and set up to go. So shall we take a look?
Yeah.
Okay, so here's my device. You can see it's been reset.
From here, I can take a picture of the QR code and it will automatically enroll the device.
Okay, it's recognized that the device belongs to the organization. I can click next and work through the setup steps. Once this is done, the device is enrolled, and depending on the device group, the device will receive its various profiles and policies. Thanks for tuning in.
Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for the latest updates.